river is rising, rising, rising. The river is rising, rising, rising. The river of joy, the river of joy.
The river is rising.
Oh, it's rising.
Your heart we're searching for. We want you and nothing more. Let your I love that line. God, we love to see you move. I love to see him move. It's amazing, too, in this time between Easter and Pentecost. And I'm sure a lot of you do know this, but there are 50 days exactly between the time that Jesus rose from the dead, the day that Jesus rose from the dead, until Pentecost is exactly 50 days. Easter, of course, has landed on a Sunday. What you may not know is that Pentecost always lands on a Sunday as well. And so there are two Sundays that we get to celebrate. But what I want to talk about this morning, just for a second, were those 50 days that happened between Sunday and Sunday. Jesus walked among the earth for 40 of those 50 days after he resurrected, and he established the kingdom of God in those 40 days. It's amazing what God can do in 40 days. And then as he ascended, he looked at the disciples and he said, I want you to pray, I want you to fast, and I want you to wait for the Holy Spirit. When the Holy Spirit has come upon you, you shall move in power and boldness. But in those 40 days, can you imagine what happened to some of the people in the 40 days that Jesus was walking the earth after most of them had seen him at Calvary on the cross, looking at him and said, you shouldn't be here right now. You should be dead. I saw you die. I saw a spear go into your side. You shouldn't be here. And Jesus is looking at them and saying, I know. I know what you think should be happening right now. But the Spirit of God has raised me up to establish his kingdom. And I'll return again. And you'll see me return again too. And what I'm getting, what I've been sensing even this week, is that there are some folks here that are just like, Lord, I am dying inside. But there are 40 days that you're going to be walking. And people are going to come up to you and say, I saw you die. You shouldn't be here right now. And you get to look at them and you get to say, I know, you're exactly right. But the Spirit of the Lord has raised me from the dead. And he has established his kingdom in this time in my life that I may preach the good news. And his Holy Spirit is on the way to fill me with boldness and with power. And that is the time that I want to celebrate. We have 50 days to celebrate. It didn't stop at his resurrection because he walked with them. And it still doesn't stop today because he sent his Holy Spirit to minister to us. We are still no longer slaves to sin. We're still no longer slaves to what we deserve. And that is a reason to celebrate, if nothing else. Can we give the Lord one more hand this morning for his faithfulness? Lord, we are so thankful. We are so thankful. We celebrate you this morning because there's no one else who could have raised themselves from the dead. Not even our own prayers could have raised you up, Lord. It had to be by your Spirit alone. And we celebrate you this morning, Lord.
Will you unravel me with a melody, and you surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies until all my fears are gone? For I'm no longer a slave to fear, for I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear, for I am a child of God. From my mother's womb, you had chosen me. Your love has called my name. Well, I've been born again into your family. Your blood flows through my veins. I'm no longer a slave. child of God. Yeah. Well, I'm no longer a slave to fear, for I am a child of God. Oh, we believe it, Lord, that I'm no longer a slave to fear, for I am a child of God.
Sing it to
me. You rescued me so I could stand and sing. I am a child of God.
You split the sea so I could walk right through it. My fears were drowned in perfect love. You rescued me so I could stand.